this lecture, we will understand what is amplitude modulation and the mathematical analysis of the amplitude modulation. So what is the amplitude modulation? In the definition of modulation, we have said that modulation is the process where the characteristics of the carrier signal is varied in accordance to the message signal. The characteristics of the carrier signal includes phase, amplitude, frequency. In the case of the amplitude modulation, the amplitude of the carrier signal will be varied in accordance to the amplitude of the message signal. So the definition of the amplitude modulation can be given by: if the amplitude of the high frequency carrier signal is varied in accordance with the instantaneous amplitude of the modulating signal or message signal, then such a technique is known as amplitude modulation. Graphically, it can be shown as: this is the message signal and this is the high frequency carrier signal, and finally this is the modulated signal. If we observe the modulated signal, then we can see that here, the amplitude of the carrier signal is varied in accordance to the amplitude of the message signal. This modulated signal has a maximum amplitude, and this maximum amplitude of the modulated signal is obtained when the message signal is at the positive peak, and it has a minimum amplitude and it is obtained when the message signal is at the negative peak. Let's see the mathematical analysis of this amplitude modulation. Let's say modulating signal or message signal MT is equal to AM cos omega MT, which can be written as AM cos 2 pi FMT. Carrier signal CT is equal to AC cos omega CT, which is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT. So the amplitude modulated signal ST is equal to AC plus MT cos 2 pi FCT. Put the value of MT as AM cos omega MT, then it can be written as ST is equal to AC plus AM cos omega MT into cos omega CT. Take AC common, then it can be written as ST is equal to AC into 1 plus AM by AC cos omega MT into cos omega CT. Replace omega CT by 2 pi FCT and replace omega MT by 2 pi FMT. This AM by AC can be written as K. So finally, equation of the modulated signal ST can be given by ST is equal to AC into 1 plus K cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Identify this as equation number 1. Here K is the modulation index and it is defined as the level of modulation which a carrier signal undergoes. Mathematically, modulation index K is equal to AM by AC. Identify this as equation number 2. From the figure of the modulated signal, we have seen that the amplitude of the modulated signal becomes maximum and minimum periodically according to the message signal. So let us determine the maximum and the minimum amplitude of the modulated signal. So from the equation 1, we can write that ST is equal to AC into 1 plus K cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Put the value of K as AM by AC and multiply AC with both the terms inside the bracket. So ST will become AC plus AM cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Identify this as equation number 3. Here in the equation of ST, if we put cos 2 pi FMT is equal to 1, then the equation 3 can be written as ST is equal to AC plus AM into cos 2 pi FCT. So the maximum amplitude of this modulated signal, A maximum is equal to AC plus AM. Identify this as equation number 4. And minimum amplitude of the modulated signal, if we put cos 2 pi FMT is equal to minus 1, then the equation 3 can be written as ST is equal to AC minus AM cos 2 pi FCT. So the minimum amplitude of the modulated signal, A minimum is equal to AC minus AM. Identify this as equation number 5. From the maximum and the minimum amplitude of the modulated signal, we can determine the amplitude of the message signal and the carrier signal. So from the equation 4 and 5, we can write that A maximum is equal to AC plus AM and A minimum is equal to AC minus AM. For the amplitude of the message signal, we need to subtract the equation number 4 from the equation number 5. So A maximum minus A minimum is equal to AC plus AM minus AC minus AM, which will result in A maximum minus A minimum is equal to 2 into AM. So amplitude of the message signal AM is equal to A maximum minus A minimum divided by 2. Identify this as equation number 6. Now for the amplitude of the carrier signal, we need to add the equation number 4 with the equation number 5. So a maximum plus a minimum is equal to AC plus AM plus AC minus AM, which will result in a maximum plus a minimum is equal to 2 into AC. So the amplitude of the carrier signal AC is equal to a maximum plus a minimum divided by 2. Identify this as equation number 7. Now the peak-to-peak maximum of the modulated signal PP max is equal to twice the maximum of the modulated signal, which is equal to 2 into MX, which further can be written as 2 into AC plus AM. Similarly, peak-to-peak minimum of the modulated signal PP min is equal to 2 into minimum value of the modulated signal. So PP min is equal to 2 into A minimum, which can be written as AC minus AM into 2. Now we know that the modulation index K is equal to AM by AC. If we put the value of AM and AC from the equation number 6 and 7, then it can be written as K is equal to A maximum minus A minimum divided by 2 divided by A maximum plus A minimum divided by 2, which can be written as K is equal to A maximum minus A minimum divided by A maximum plus A minimum. So the modulation index K is equal to AM by AC, which is equal to A maximum minus A minimum divided by A maximum plus A minimum. And the percentage modulation index is equal to K into 100%. Level of modulation depends upon this value of K. If K is less than 1, then the modulated signal has under modulation. If K is equal to 1, then the modulated signal has perfect modulation. If K is greater than 1, then the modulated signal has over modulation. Bandwidth of the modulated signal. From the equation number 1, we can write ST is equal to AC into 1 plus K cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Multiply AC with both the terms, then it can be written as take AC into K by 2 common from the second term, then it can be written as ST is equal to AC into cos 2 pi FCT plus AC into K divided by 2, 2 into cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. We know that 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos A minus B plus cos A plus B. If we apply this formula in the following equation, then it can be written as ST is equal to AC into cos 2 pi FCT plus AC into K divided by 2 cos 2 pi into FC minus FM into T plus cos 2 pi into FC plus FM into T. Identify this as equation number 8. Here, FC is the frequency of the carrier signal, FM is the frequency of the message signal, FC minus FM, which is equal to F minimum, is the frequency of the lower sideband, and FC plus FM, which is equal to F maximum, is the frequency of the upper sideband. If we multiply AC into K divided by 2 with both the terms, then it can be written as ST is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus AC into K divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus AC into K divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. AC into cos 2 pi FCT is the equation of the carrier signal. AC into K divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T is the equation of the lower sideband signal, and AC into K cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T is the equation of the upper sideband signal. So the bandwidth of the amplitude modulated signal BW is the difference between the maximum frequency and the minimum frequency. So BW is equal to F maximum minus F minimum. Put the value of F maximum as FC plus FM and F minimum as FC minus FM. After performing the addition, bandwidth of the amplitude modulated signal BW is equal to 2FM. Now, from the equation 8, the amplitude modulated signal can be written as ST is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus AC into K by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. As I have said earlier, this amplitude modulated signal is consist of carrier signal, which is equal to AC into cos 2 pi FCT, upper sideband signal, which is equal to AC into K divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T, and lower sideband signal, which is equal to AC into K divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T. All of them are cosine signals. Power of the cosine signal can be given by Vrms square by R, where Vrms is equal to Vm by root 2. Identify this as equation number 9. Here, Vrms is the RMS value of the cosine signal and Vm is the amplitude of the cosine signal. So power of the amplitude modulated signal is the sum of the power of these signals combined. So PST is equal to power of carrier signal plus power of upper sideband signal plus power of the lower sideband signal. So P of ST is equal to PC plus PUSB plus PLSB. Now substitute the amplitude of the carrier sideband signal, upper sideband signal and the lower sideband signal in the equation number 9. Then it can be written as PST is equal to AC divided by root 2 whole square divided by R plus K into AC divided by 2 into root 2 whole square divided by R plus K into AC divided by 2 into root 2 whole square divided by R, which can be simplified as multiply R in the denominator of the numerator. Then it can be written as PST is equal to AC square by 2R plus K square AC square by 8R plus K square AC square by 8R. Add second and third term as 2K square AC square divided by 8R. Simplify the equation as PST is equal to AC square divided by 2R plus K square AC square divided by 4R. Take AC square by 2R common from the equation, then it can be written as PST is equal to AC square divided by 2R 1 plus K square by 2. Replace AC square by 2R as PC. So PST is equal to PC into 1 plus K square by 2, which can be further simplified as PST divided by PC is equal to 2 plus K square by 2. Identify this as equation number 10. Current in the amplitude modulation. From the equation number 10, we can write that PST is equal to PC into 2 plus K square by 2. Put the value of PST as I square R, PC as IC square R, where I is the modulated signal current and IC is the carrier signal current. Eliminate R from both the sides, then it can be written as I square is equal to IC square into 2 plus K square by 2. Simplify the equation and finally it can be written as I is equal to IC into root over 2 plus K square divided by 2. Voltage in the amplitude modulation. Again from the equation number 10, we can write PST is equal to PC into 2 plus K square by 2. Replace PST by V square by R and PC by VC square by R, where V is the modulated signal voltage and VC is the carrier signal voltage. Eliminate R from the two sides and it can be written as V square is equal to VC square into 2 plus K square by 2. After simplification, this equation can be written as V is equal to VC into root over 2 plus K square by 2. Now, the efficiency of the amplitude modulated signal. Efficiency eta can be given by the ratio of usable power and the total power. Here, in the amplitude modulated signal, we have two sidebands and a carrier signal. Both the sidebands carry the same information, so the usable power is the power of either sideband. And usable power can be given by power of upper sideband, which is equal to power of lower sideband. Now, the upper sideband signal is equal to AC into K divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T, and the lower sideband signal is equal to AC into K divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T. Power of upper or lower sideband signal is equal to VRMS by R, which can be written as VM by root 2 whole square divided by R. If we put the value of VM as AC into K divided by 2, then it can be written as, after simplification, the power of upper or lower sideband signal can be given by K square into AC square divided by 8R. Now, from the equation of the efficiency of the amplitude modulated signal, we can replace the usable power by K square into AC square divided by 8R and the total power as PC into 2 plus K square divided by 2. PC can be replaced as AC square by 2R. So eta is equal to the ratio of K square into AC square by 8R and AC square by 2R into 2 plus K square divided by 2. Eliminate the common terms from the numerator and the denominator. Now simplify the equation. Finally, efficiency can be given by eta is equal to K square divided by 4 plus 2K square. If we had considered both the sidebands, then efficiency will become twice of eta. So the efficiency is equal to 2 into K square divided by 4 plus 2K square, which can be written as efficiency is equal to K square divided by 2 plus K square. If we take modulation index K is equal to 1, then the efficiency of the amplitude modulated signal with the single sideband eta is equal to 1 whole square divided by 4 plus 2 into 1 whole square into 100%, which is equal to 16.66%, and with both the sidebands it becomes 33.33%. The amount of power dissipated by the carrier signal on the modulation index k is equal to 1 is equal to PST divided by PC, which is equal to 2 plus 1 whole square divided by 2. So PC is equal to 66.66% of PST. So in the process of the amplitude modulation, 66.66% of the total power is wasted on the carrier signal, which is highly inefficient. That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.